By the end of this video, you will learn how to create a grain shading effect in DaVinci Resolve. Basically, we need only two nodes to create this style in black and white, or three nodes for color. But we can make a more interesting result with one node at the beginning or at the end. For a better understanding of what is going on, let's go to the gradient ramp and start from the middle. Posterize image. For someone who doesn't know, posterization of an image is the conversion of a continuous gradation of tone to several regions of fewer tones, causing abrupt changes from one tone to another. There are two ways to posterize image in DaVinci Resolve, using my completely free DCTL, which I made during my ride on the train and you can grab it from the description, or using a native effect called Abstraction, which doesn't work perfectly for us. The difference is next. In my DCTL, the brightest and the darkest point is always white and black, and there are no transitions between tones. In the abstraction effect, when you apply it, you should disable everything and then enable quantization. Decrease softness. And you can't just put it at the very minimum, because there is a bug, as you can see. So the minimum acceptable value is 0.012. It is not even perfect. Unnecessary smooth transitions. The darkest and the brightest are just grays, because it calculates average values of the range. DCTL. Abstraction. DCTL for sure. Now, we have to somehow colorize our gradations of gray. We need to build a gradient map. The only way I found how to make it is a default effect called false color. In the plugin mode, we need to choose creative. In the style, we can leave jet as is. We have 5 steps in our posterization, so the number of bands 5 is what we are looking for. But here is the thing. The brightest point is 100, but we can't choose it now. So we have to add one more band, which automatically becomes 100. Then we have to adjust one of the lower bands to 100. Remove the band we added, and we still can choose 100 for other bands. What values to put in the top and bottom? We made 5 steps, the darkest is 0. So our next step brightness is 100 divided by 5 steps minus 1 equals 25. Next is 50 and next is 75 and the last is 100. You can open your waveform and in the settings choose percentage to briefly understand the values to put. The top and the bottom have to be the same. Here you choose your colors. I built up this gradient map, which you can see here. To remove this from your image, just disable this checkbox. Great. So now we have to add our grain transitions between tones. You can take whatever you want, film grain or fractal noise and adjust them. I will use my DCTL FX remix with pixel mix mode. It will be faster for me. And you can grab it too. I choose the pixel mix mode, click on high and low thresholds and decrease distance to 0. We mixed our source pixels randomly. Now we are going to key output gain and adjust its value. As you can see, our image is revealing with grainy transitions. If you want to make grain bigger, go to node sizing and zoom it. That's it. Let's go to our footage. Posterize. Gradient map. Pixel mix with changed key output and size. If you want to add more style to it, you can add a new node at the end with FX remix DCTL in pixel fall mode, change threshold, distance and angle, just for example. Or the same, but at the beginning. Adjust lift, gamma and gain, to achieve the style you want. Also, you can use the first and the last nodes simultaneously, but it could be too much. You can always check how it is looking with less or more steps in posterization. That's all. All links in the description. Please, like and subscribe to support me. And leave me your thoughts in the comments.